All right, this video is meant to introduce the accessibility features of MyOpenMath and how to configure them properly. This video is going to be designed primarily for like an accessibility support person to be able to help a student configure their system properly. All right, so we're going to look at, there's sort of two cases that we have to look at. One is a direct login case, and another one is where you're accessing from an LMS. So if you're accessing directly, in other words, you're logging directly into MyOpenMath, then the student is going to want to click on or select user settings on the top here. They can also click the little gear icon next to their name here. That will get them to the same place. And this brings up places where they can, you know, change their name and things like that. But we're going to go down to the accessibility settings. And for math display, MathJax 3 honestly has perfectly good screen reader support by default. There's also an option for with screen reader support pre-enabled, which enables a slightly different screen reader support. The student and you may want to play around with sort of options. I'll talk about this more a bit later, but we'll leave that alone for now. And second is graph display. If a student is using a screen reader, or is in other words otherwise sight limited, they may want to choose the text alternatives, which will replace graphs with tables or charts instead. And for drawing entry, there's an option for keyboard and text-based drawing entry if a student, again, either has visual issues or can't use a mouse well. This would be an option. For the text editor, normally there's a rich text editor with a bunch of formatting buttons. If that's annoying and gets in the way, you can switch to plain text entry. And for math entry, the default is to use an equation editor, and there's an option to disable it. So let me now show you how you would access those same features if you were accessing from an LMS. So if you were using MyOpenMath from an LMS, you would need to click on one of the MyOpenMath assignments in the LMS and start or resume the assignment. Then in the top header, there is a more options or more menu. Visually, it's three vertical dots. The alt text on it is more or more options. And if you click that, there's an option for user preferences, which brings up those same accessibility and display preferences. Do note that after you update these or save these, you may need to go back and reload the assignment in order for the changes to take effect. But that's the place where we can change those settings. Now let's talk about what they actually do. So hold on. So if we're in a assignment in MyOpenMath, to enter an answer, a student often has to type algebraic expressions. For a visual student or a student who can use a mouse, there is a equation editor that they can use to enter their answer. Now, even if a student doesn't want to disable this, they can still just use the keyboard using things like the slash key to start a fraction, and they can type SQRT to create a square root. They can use the caret key to create an exponent. The thing to be aware of is that, like, after doing a exponent or something like that, to get out of the exponent, you often have to either hit the right arrow or the space button to bring yourself back down to the main level. But if this is too annoying or difficult, let me show you a couple other things. And then some questions will include graphs like this, and some questions will include graphing entry, where students have to draw a graph by clicking two points. So now we're going to take a look and see what the accessibility features let us do. So I'm going to do a few things. First, I'm going to switch to our text alternatives for graphs. I'm going to switch to keyboard entry for drawings, and I'm going to switch the math entry to calculator style, and I'm going to hit update. And we are going to have to reload the assessment now, or reload the page, in order to see the difference. So you'll notice here now, in our entry box, we no longer see the equation editor. The upside of this is, it's much easier to type and sort of see what's being typed, or have the screen reader work with that. And here we just use calculator style notation. So that means things like, again, a caret for a square, a slash for a fraction, SQRT for a square root, always making sure to put parentheses around the input to any function. And the one important thing to remember here is to use parentheses when necessary. So like if you want to enter a fraction with an expression in the numerator, you would need parentheses around that numerator in order to indicate that all of it is in the numerator. Otherwise, you'd end up with only the 2 being divided by 3. Right? But it's calculator style notation, and then it does do a live preview here, which the screen reader can read, so that they can verify that the system is interpreting it the way that they intended. But this calculator style entry is definitely probably going to be the easiest way for someone primarily using a keyboard to enter an answer in MyOpenMath. All right, so now let's go ahead and look at some of the other features. So remember, the second question previously had a graph. Now with our text alternatives, we're going to be seeing a table instead. So the table is going to have a table of values for the function. And hopefully you can then, the student can then use this table to go ahead and answer the question, just like if they had a graph. And again, here, this question is asking for a fractional answer. You would do the same thing. You would just use a slash to enter a fraction. So 1/3 for 1/3. Same idea. And then for our drawing entry question, remember this one, we used to have to graph a line. So now it's saying, hey, we want to sketch a graph of this function. So here we're going to graph, here's the graph we're going to add a drawing to. We have a graph with a window of -5 to 5 for x and y from -5 to 5. And so the elements are going to draw. We don't have any elements yet, so we want to add a new drawing element. We want to add a line. And again, this is all intended to be used by keyboard. So then we'd hit add. And it says line, enter 2 points on the line. So then you would enter 2 points on the line, entering the points in standard ordered pair notation with parentheses around them and with a comma separating the points. So here we could do, for example, 0, -2, and 2, -1 to draw the line. And if we need to add another line, we can go down and add another line. We can remove it if we don't want it. And of course, when we're done, we hit submit, and great, we got that question right. All right, so those are the sort of core accessibility features built into MyOpenMath. One last thing to mention is on the equations. By default, if you haven't enabled anything else, if you haven't changed any settings, then MyOpenMath automatically, we use MathJax for rendering mathematics, and MathJax automatically inserts a hidden MathML. And most screen readers nowadays can read MathML. Not all of them do it well, though. So if you have any problems, if you run into situations where the screen reader just is not reading the equations correctly, then what you can do is select the equation. So you can tab to the equation and then press space. Or if you're using a mouse, you can right click. And in the menu, go down to accessibility and enable the act and turn on activate. And I don't know what just happened. I don't know why it disappeared on me there. I'm just going to reload here. There we are. And we are now activated. And what this does is, instead of relying on the MathML and having the screen reader convert the MathML into speech, it uses its own custom speech engine to create an ARIA label with a description, with a, you know, text, a readable description of the equation. And oftentimes these can be either the same as, or sometimes better than the generated ones by the screen reader. So that might be a good feature to enable, is the Again, accessibility menu, activate. And there's options here to configure the rules and customize it a bunch if there's need to do so. All right, hopefully that helps you help a student who it needs to take advantage of the accessibility features in MyOpenMath.